Hi friends, if you like my videos, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.
Hi friends, my name is Fanindra. So in this video, I'm going to explain to you about monoclonal antibodies. So I'm going to explain to you about the definition of these monoclonal antibodies and also how these monoclonal antibodies has been formed. Also, I'm going to take an example so that you can properly understand. So firstly, if you see here, this monoclonal antibodies extraction was firstly discovered by Kohler and Milstein in 1975. So coming to the definition of the monoclonal antibody, plasma cell will get combined with myeloma cell and forms hybridoma cell. And that hybridoma cell has a capacity to form a specific antibody known as monoclonal antibodies. So you can understand this definition when I show you the diagram. So here is the diagram normally. So what is the given in the definition? Plasma cell will get combined with the myeloma cell, right? So how firstly, how this plasma cell has been formed, you have to know that. Because if you see here, this B cell, normally when the antigens will get injected into the body or as into an organism, then what happens is that immune system will get activated. So due to the activation of the immune system, what happens is that releasing of the B cells takes place. And normally from which part this B cells has been released? From the part of spleen. From the spleen, these B cells will get released out. So now what happens is that this B cell has a capacity to absorb this antigen, to intake the antigen. So when the antigen will get received by this B cell, then what happens is that T helper cell will get will send out signals to this B cell. So what happens is that this B cell will get mature to form plasma cell. So now what happens is that this plasma cell has a capacity to form antibodies. So now from where this plasma cells has been formed? From the spleen. That's nothing but the B cell has been transformed into plasma cell. So we can say it has been protruded out from the spleen. Okay, so what is the definition given here is that plasma cell will get combined with the myeloma cell and forms hybridoma cell. So this is the plasma cell which consists of antibodies will get combined with the myeloma cell to form hybridoma cell. And now here what happens is that this hybridoma cell which has been formed consists of antibodies and undergoes mitotic division. So if you see here, when this undergoes mitotic division, then what happens is that similar structure of its daughter individuals will be formed. So if you see here, many clones has been formed from this hybridoma cell, from the single hybridoma cell only many daughter individuals has been protruded out. So I have mentioned here mono because single individual for monoclones, as these are all are known as clones, and all of these are formed from the single individual of hybridoma cell, it is said to be as monoclones. And if you see here, these are the antibodies, right? So the antibodies which are present in this monoclones are known as said to be as monoclonal antibodies. So normally extraction of these antibodies takes place from the monoclones, okay? And that antibodies are said to be as monoclonal antibodies. And next, here I am going to explain this whole process in the step-by-step process by taking an example of rat. So here totally 7 steps are there. Remember here, 7 steps. First step is injection, second step is fusion, third one is hybridoma formation, fourth one is division, fifth is testing, culturing and extraction. So if you see here, I'm going to take an example of rat. So coming to the first step, injection. So if you see here, this is the rat, and normally when the antigens will get injected into the organism, so the organism example which we took here is rat, right? So when these antibodies will get injected into the rat, then what happens is that the immune system which is present in the rat will get activated. So due to the activation of this activation of that immune system, what happens is that releasing of B cells takes place, releasing of B cells. And these B cells, from where it get released? From the spleen, which I have said you here, all of these B cells will get released from the spleen. So these B cells will consist of antibodies. And normally these B cells will get combined with the myeloma cells, right? So when these B cells will get combined with the myeloma cells, then it leads to the formation of, normally this is the fusion, how the fusion takes place. The B cell part and the myeloma cell part will get fused over. So due to the fusion, what happens? There is a formation of hybridoma cell. So come into the second step, fusion. So here fusion takes place. So due to the fusion, what happens? Hybridoma formation takes place. Here is the third step, hybridoma formation takes place. So normally, if you see here, coming to the fourth step, division. So here hybridoma cell, which consists of antibodies, will undergo mitotic division. So as we know that there is an antibodies produce, which are present in this hybridoma cell, when it undergoes mitotic division, then several number of daughter individuals has been released, right? And within the daughter individuals, I am going to take a single individual, if you see here, and I can't draw more because when you zoom the daughter individual, it looks like this. Normally different antibodies will be present. If you see here, these are the different antibodies, and when it undergoes fusion, and if you see here, when it undergoes fusion, then it leads to the formation of hybridoma cells. It leads to the formation of hybridoma cells. So from the hybridoma cells, what I have said you, when it undergoes mitosis, then many monoclonals will be released out. That is nothing but daughter individuals has been released out. So all of the daughter individuals will get separated individually. So if you see here, testing, how the testing takes place by the separation process. So normally all of the daughter individuals will get separated, and when all of these daughter individuals get separated, then it will be tested under HAT medium. HAT medium, wait a second. HAT medium. In the presence of the HAT medium, all of the daughter individuals which has been formed from this hybridoma cell will be placed. Each of the daughter individual will be placed in each well. So these are wells. So there are totally 4 wells I have drawn here. There will be many wells, depends upon your activity. So if you see here, only one individual will be presented over in a one well. Okay, so it will be separated individually to produce specific antibody. So this is about the testing. And next, coming to the 6th step, it undergoes culturing process. So after the culturing process, then what happens? It undergoes purification process. So when this purification, and normally what is the main function of this culturing and purification is nothing but to finalize the product, this culturing process takes place. Okay, and when this daughter individuals which has been released out will get cultured and will get purified, and normally this will the monoclonal antibodies which will be present, and that monoclonal antibodies will be extracted out here. So if you see here, these are the monoclones, right? And within the monoclones, what happens? Antibodies will be present, and that antibodies which are present in the monoclones will be extracted out. So this is so the extracted antibodies are said to be as monoclonal antibodies. So you have to understand here, because there is no digital explanation here, so you have to understand by yourself. So this is the explanation of this monoclonal antibodies, how the formation takes place. And now if you see the definition, you can understand properly, totally you can understand the definition. Plasma cell will get combined with myeloma cells, right? And that forms hybridoma, right? This hybrid individual, that's nothing but hybridoma, and that hybridoma has a capacity to form specific antibodies known as monoclonal antibodies. So from the hybridoma cells only these monoclonal antibodies has been produced, right? So these are known as monoclonal antibodies. So this is about the monoclonal antibody explanation. So if you like my explanation, please like my video and share it to your friends, and if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.